Hey, today we are going to talk about redefining your why. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I feel like I'm doing this every video, but I just want to give a shout out to everyone who has put comments and took the time out to share their story with me. I feel like we kind of built like a little family, and I do. If I've missed your comment, I'm really sorry, but I try to respond to everybody because I understand even during this process when you're researching, if you're at the beginning and you're researching and trying to find out information, it's very important that you get answers as soon as you can because you're kind of wanting someone that's kind of either on the journey with you, been through it, to kind of give you the answers that you need. So today, speaking of that, I've kind of gone through all of the stories that everyone has kind of shared with me, and it seems like it's like a combination. Some of you are starting your journey, a few of you are like maybe already a few weeks in, and then some of you have maybe started and then you're restarting again. So I had another video scheduled for today, but I felt like this video was more important than the one I wanted to put out, and I feel like maybe I should put this one out first before I kind of do the measuring veggies tips and other videos like that, which are coming soon, what I eat in a day, things like that. But for this one, I think this is the start of your whole journey, that if you narrow this piece down, it just makes it a little easier. And my husband and I were having a discussion, and I think he was sitting there, and he's at 47 pounds, I think, maybe more as of today. So combined, my husband and I have lost over 100 pounds. Isn't that crazy? 100 pounds, like never in a million years would I have thought that would even been something we would have tried to achieve. But he also made a comment about kind of staying focused and like why he's doing it. And I feel like redefining your why is so important when you're starting this journey, because you know, there's so many reasons some people start a journey. Oh, they want to do it because of this, they want to do it because of that. And I've said it before in my other videos, but I feel like sometimes we don't make a decision about changing our lives because we're not angry, or there's nothing that makes us, we're too complacent. Like you can be at a job and it's paying you the right money, you got good benefits, you probably could be making more money, but we're comfortable, we're complacent. So you usually don't make a decision, and then, oh, one day something happens and someone says something crazy and you wanna leave. That made you angry, that made you upset, that made you uncomfortable. So now you start looking for a job and you find an even better one, right? So I think kind of the weight loss situation kind of happened like that for me. It was at a point where I just had enough. I didn't want to be the person uncomfortable shopping, not being in any family pictures. I had enough, and it was time for me to make a decision. So even there's some of these tips, I have three tips for you today. And I feel like I wish I would have known these three, because I feel like when you define that, even to look back on, it would have helped me a lot, okay? So the first tip that I have for you, I actually did during my process, and I go back and look at it. So the first tip I would say is, get a calendar. Like this is just like a blank one for August, because what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fill it out with you guys again, because you know how I've been talking about losing those 20 pounds. I've just been lollygagging, doing so many other stuff. School's about to start. I need to make sure if I wanna drop those 20 pounds, I don't just maintain. You know, I've been maintaining my weight for the little while. I wanna drop those 20. I've made a decision and that's what I wanna do. So I'm gonna take this calendar, and I don't believe in starting on a Monday. I feel like I forgot what's the quote, but I know they always say first best time was yesterday and the next best time is today, something like that. But you get the picture. But I'm rambling, I'm sorry. But basically what I want you guys to do is let's block off, get a calendar if you have one, or watch this video through and then come back and follow these steps. But I'm just gonna do it with you guys because I think like it's more important. So today is the 12th, right? So most people start on a Monday. So what you're gonna do is go to your Monday calendar, right? So if that's your first week, what I would suggest is for your first week, set yourself a goal. I mean, as a coach, I find that when you have more weight to lose, maybe you can lose more the first week, but everybody is different. So for me, I think a reasonable goal for me for the first week would be 5 pounds. So if I'm gonna start, let's say Monday the 16th, by the 20th, I should lose 5 pounds. So I'm writing that on the calendar. 5 pounds down, okay? So what I'm gonna do is every week after that, I'm gonna write 2 pounds, okay? And what you also can do is you can put a number, like whatever you weigh, write what's 5 pounds less, right? So if you're at 200 pounds, you get what I'm saying? Then you're gonna be at 195. So put 195 on the 20th, okay? And you're gonna write that down for each day. And this is just for August, but I suggest you do it on your regular calendar. And I'm telling you, it's crazy because it'll keep you accountable as well. Because if you know that this plan works, which for me it did, and you're keeping yourself realistic, if you go back on that calendar and it comes a day and you haven't lost how much you should, it's because you're slacking, right? You're just wasting weeks and money, okay? We're paying for this program, right? And we don't want to do that. So I find just writing this down and putting the numbers, like in an ink pen, writing it down, having it ready to go. When you go back and look at this, not only will it give you like kind of like good little like a great journal to go back and look at to see how much you've achieved, but I feel like it also keeps you accountable, because sometimes we're going along thinking that this one little thing is not affecting us. And if you're putting 2 pounds per week after your first week and you're not achieving that, something's wrong. Now don't get me wrong, like I said, I said in other videos, even if you lose that 1 pound sometimes or whatever, you're still losing pure fat after a certain week. So those first 2 weeks, if you guys are just starting and you've been eating bad food, I feel like your first 2 weeks, if you're following this plan correctly and using the tips I've given in other videos, you should be dropping weight in those first 2 pounds. So write it down. That is my first tip. Write it in a calendar, okay? I don't care, a calendar that you see. If you have a birthday coming up, go on and do it for like the next 6 weeks, okay? And say, by this day, if I lose this amount every single week, I should be this weight. And what ends up happening too is you'll probably pass that goal. I'm just saying, if you do 2 pounds every week, I'm pretty sure you'll pass it, because there's gonna be some really good weeks and there might be some where you won't lose as much, but you're gonna be losing. So do that, trust me. Go fill out that calendar, get a copy, use the one that, you know, the little flip ones I have at work that you put on your wall, and fill that out, okay? So that's the main thing, all right? So tip number two, okay? This is something I didn't do, and I'm beating myself up because I wish I did, because even I have little journals that I wrote, and sometimes when you go back and look at that, you don't even realize how far you come. And if you're somebody who's in your first week, right, and you're making a decision today to change your life, you have to understand that you are in a situation and you're gonna be so different in a month, in 2 months, in 3 months, I mean, in 5 months. You could be a completely different person. Trust me, I know. And I'm not saying like, oh, weight changes you. I'm just saying, as far as your energy, the way you feel about yourself, your confidence level, the way you dress, the way you carry yourself, you know, if you're enhancing one thing about your body, you tend to want to enhance like other things mentally. You get what I'm saying? You're just mentally growing, and it kind of teaches you that you could do things that you didn't think you could, okay? So it's very important. So tip number two, write a letter. Most people say write down your why. That's good too. So write down that why, but I want you to write a letter, okay? And don't judge me, but I'm gonna read you guys a letter that I kind of wrote to myself. I have it on my computer here, right? So I wanted to go through these steps just like I'm going through them with you guys. And here's a letter, an example. And I feel like you should break it down to who you are, like I am Alicia, whatever, you know, and what you want and why you want this, basically, and how you're gonna do this and when you're gonna get it done. And you also wanna put a little statement in there if you're reading this and thinking about giving up, give yourself some encouragement. And I'm just gonna read the letter fully so you get an idea, okay? No judgment, right? Here's my letter. It says, "Dear Alicia, you have come so far, and don't take this for granted. You have surpassed your first goal you told your coach months ago. However, this made you realize that you can get to your ultimate goal, which is to feel fully comfortable in a bikini, possibly a thigh gap, okay? And a few abs in the future. But you need to stop playing around and get to your goal now. Don't waste another day. Hopefully, the second time you're reading this, you can put a bikini picture right next to this letter. and show your daughter that weight isn't everything, but if you want to achieve something, you can. You are no longer the mom that is never in pictures and that is embarrassed to go shopping and try on things. Your personality can now match inside and out. In the case that you're reading this and have not completed your goal and are thinking about giving up, remember, keep pushing. You want this, and we don't know if we have tomorrow. So make a change today. They said you couldn't lose a breast size. You did. They said you wouldn't drop 50 pounds. You did. So now finish and see it through. And remember, you a bad. Keep pushing. Okay? So I'm telling you, like, write yourself a letter, okay? Put it in a form so that when you're going back to read it, there's gonna be a time where you wanna quit, I'm telling you. Especially if some of you are deeper into your journey, there gets a time where you're like, why am I still doing this? Like, 1 pound a week or 2 pounds a week? Like, what is it? I'm telling you, just go back and read that letter, but you need to have a letter. So right now, I'm telling you, the mind frame you're gonna write the letter in, 5 months from now, it's just put it, formulate it in a way where you can go back and really appreciate how far you come. Because I'm telling you, if you're going to push through and you've made a mental decision to do this, it's crazy. Because right now you're sitting there, you're researching these videos, you're looking for everything, and you don't know if you can do it. You still don't know if you can do it. And even if you found my videos and you've been watching for a while, you might be at the beginning of your journey, you don't think it's going to happen. It's going to happen if you do the work. And I'm telling you, this has to be, I'm not saying it's the best plan out of all of the plans that are out there. It's just the one that has been the most convenient and somewhat easy for me as far as what I need to do and getting results, okay? So write that letter to yourself, put it somewhere, keep it, have a copy of it, and I would suggest have a digital copy of it, right? So that you could go back, if you lose the paper copy, you could go back and look at it, because I'm telling you, I'm gonna come back to you guys and read this. Hopefully when I have that thigh gap and those abs, or even when I feel comfortable in that bikini, and I want to be able to read this and say, I did it. And come Monday, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just keep up with my journey, and I'm going to kind of do like a video diary of the first week so you guys could see. Oh, that's so embarrassing for me, but so you guys could really see everything I'm going through. So stay tuned for that, because that's coming soon, okay? Now the third tip. I don't know if you guys ever watched this show, but it's called Mary Jane, right? It used to play on, I think it was playing on BET or Lifetime, I don't know. But Mary Jane is with Gabrielle Union. I love that show, right? Now, the thing I would notice she would have all the time were these sticky notes, okay? So I would suggest writing little notes to yourself on these sticky notes. Even if you want to put like little snippets of your why, or if you just want to put, you've got this, keep pushing, 5 more pounds to go, 3 more pounds to go. These little sticky notes can be so important, because there's some days literally you have so many other things on your mind besides weight loss. And I know this is a weight loss channel and all we're talking about is this constantly, but there were some days I woke up and like I had to remind myself, I was like, oh, I'm on this plan. You know, like I have another goal. You know what I'm saying? Because life happens. There's so many other things that are going on and you need to stay focused. I'm telling you, one on your bathroom mirror, one on your refrigerator, and even one in your car, or one on, like, I have my work computer right here at home. So I put it on the computer because it's very important that you have it in these places where you look often, because it kind of just slaps you in the head, especially on the refrigerator. And the pantry would be a good one. It just reminds you that like you have a bigger goal. Like you can have whatever you were thinking about later in moderation when you figure out how to maintain that properly. It's just not that important right now. And I just feel like when I used to see her with those little sticky notes, it makes a difference. Having those little sticky notes, just reminders. It's almost like if some of you are in the process of losing weight right now and you know that someone just noticed that you were losing weight, that's like a little sticky note, because that's like a little piece of motivation that someone's like, hey, or even if you keep up with how much you've lost, like you could put, you've lost this much already. So you remind yourself that you're doing this. You're doing this and we're gonna finish. So if you guys, again, if you guys have any questions, leave them in the comments. But I want to know, like, what are your 3 tips when it comes to redefining your why and motivation? Like, tell me what you do to kind of keep you going. And you guys, thank you for so much support on the channel. And again, if you have any questions, please let me know. Bye, guys.